If y'all want to see badge progress like this, get ready because I'm about to show y'all the best way to get your badges.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? You are now tuned in to Mal TV. And today, I'm going to be showing y'all the fastest way to hit 99 and get every single one of your badges, okay? So make sure you watch this video all the way through. Drop a like, subscribe if you're new, and let's get it. I like a color lady, yeah. Yeah, she know that I can order us. Yeah, she know that I'll make it right back. I feel like it's fun and I just got a tap. I did it again, man. I just got a pack. Alright, so to do this method, what you're going to need to do is find these orange NPCs going around the city, okay? They're going to have an orange exclamation point over the head. If it's not orange, it's not the one you're looking for, alright? But what you're going to do is talk to them and they're going to give you a task. And then it's going to tell you that something's been added to your journal, okay? And just to give you another example, this is what the people are going to look like. And they're going to tell you that they have a location on the map that you need to go to do these things. And every time I said, whenever you get a task, it's going to pop up in your journal. If it does not pop up in your journal, then I don't know what you're doing. All right. Something went wrong. But what you want to do after that is you want to hit start and then you want to go to the city and then you want to click on your journal. Okay. Whenever you click on your journal, you're going to see there are warehouse challenges and then there are objective challenges, okay? The objective challenges are not what you want to do because it gives you extra VC, but it doesn't give you double XP, okay? So just go to the warehouse challenges and you'll see, I think I already did one of them, but you see they'll tell you what to do and who you'll play against, and sometimes I think it'll tell you who you play with. But pretty much all you have to do to get the double XP is just play the people and win the game. Now, to find these areas on the map, all you're gonna want to do is pull out your map and you're gonna see these bright orange squares on the map that kind of look like the daily objective squares, but they're gonna be located at any of the garages, okay? And it doesn't matter which garage you go to unless you're looking for a specific mission or objective to do, but it's gonna be located anywhere around the map on any of these garages or like warehouses in each of the affiliations, you know, like blocks. Now once you found where these locations are, they'll say something like the factory, but sometimes they'll be different and they'll say things like the warehouse. It really depends where you go, but they're gonna have the same things in them anyway. But all you want to do is walk up to them and it'll say play warehouse objective or play warehouse challenge, okay? Whenever it does, you just click A or X if you're on PlayStation, and it's gonna load you into the actual game. Now, once you're in the game, you're gonna see this warehouse has Kevin McHale, Robert Parrish, and Larry Bird, and it'll let you quit whenever you want, and it doesn't count on your record. There's nothing bad that comes from this, so if you ever just wanna quit them, you can always go back and do them. But what you're gonna wanna do in this is score as much as you can, or pretty much do whatever you want to get whatever badge you want. So if you wanna get defense badges, do a bunch of defensive stuff, get playmaking badges, throw alleys, get assists, shooting badges, you know, shoot, and finishing, just dunk. For this game, I was just going for defense and for playmaking because I'm not too worried about my shooting badge right now because you can really shoot without shooting badges on this game, but I need a quick first step and handles for days, unpluggable, things like that. So for this one, I'm just mostly getting playmaking and defense, and you see it does give you double my points and double badge points. You saw I got one playmaking badge, and you see the points it has. You usually get like 10 or 9k for this, but you're getting 20k because it's double, and also get a defense badge. So the better you do, the more badge you're gonna get. It doesn't affect your record, and you can't get park rep for this, but you can see right there I only have 2 shooting badges and I just got my 4th playmaking badge, okay? And I'm gonna do shooting after this game, and I'm gonna show y'all the method that I use for getting shooting badges while we're doing this. So let's walk right back in because it does let you do it twice. I'm not sure if it lets you do it 3 times, but I don't think it does, okay? So I went back in. You can see it's the exact same game, all right? And I'm pretty much just going to be doing shooting badges this time because I want to get a couple more shooting badges before I do go to the park. All right, so this is the method I'm using. What I'm doing is just going up the court, and then I'm really just letting it fly whenever I'm open. But the best way to get open I've seen against these computers is to go up the court, hold RT, and then pull the right trigger back, okay? And when you put the right trigger back, you'll be able to get open a lot. And sometimes when you go up the court, they'll just sag off a little bit. You can do a little step back. But you see, I'm just doing the pullback, and then I'm just greening it, all right? And this is the best way to do it. I mean, it's kind of hard to make every single shot just because the warehouse is, it's just weird. I don't know. But you see the double my points, and you see the double badge points, and I got a shooting badge, And these games don't take long, I'm telling you guys, all right? So, you see the badge points that I got from this. I got 2,976 from making 6 out of 8 threes. So, if I would've went like 8 out of 8, I might've got like 3,500. And then that turns into like 7,000, all right? So, that's a lot of badge points to be getting every time. But that's pretty much what I'm doing with this. And if you want to get shooting badges, you're just going to want to go up the court, do pullbacks, and most of the time, you'll be wide open, okay? So, after I got out the game, this was my second time doing it, and I tried to go back in the third time, but it didn't work. So, I'm not sure if it's just certain ones that let you go on multiple times or, you know, whatever it is, but I went and even checked my journal, and if it says the game is done, then that means I can't play it anymore. But that's the method for you right there. I think it's pretty simple. You know, if you have any questions, just message me on Twitter or comment down below. But hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure y'all getting all those badges, getting the 99 overall as fast as you can. Make sure you drop a like on the video if you appreciate this. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'm going to catch y'all in the next video.